If you're sick of cleaning hacks that don't work, welcome back to Do It at a Dime. I've got 5 incredible secrets you can find all at the dollar store. And yes, these are game changers. Let's hit it.
I'm using a lot of really unconventional tricks in this video, but this is my secret. Not only are the spaces really dirty, I want this stuff to actually work. These are things you did not expect, but you can try today and you'll be like, thanks, Kathryn. All right, we are jumping in with some hydrogen peroxide. Just trust me on this one. You also wanna go to the mop essentials section. You've probably seen this in your store. Grab a broom handle if you don't have one, and you're also gonna grab one of these scrub brushes. What if I told you I could save you an hour and save your back at the same time? I'm not kidding. You're gonna sprinkle some baking soda right on the grout lines of your floor. You're probably thinking, is this actually gonna work though if I try this? Just yes, I've done this for literal years. Then you're gonna pour the hydrogen peroxide over top, and the upgrade that will save your back too and make it so much faster is using the broom as your scrub brush. No longer do you have to be on your hands and knees scrubbing the grout. You can do this standing up. My bathroom's pretty big and I can do the entire thing in about 15 minutes. By the time you get to the other end of the bathroom, the baking soda will have dried. So you can go through and use that same brush just to sweep it up and put it straight into a dustpan. Remember, the grout's not dirty here. It's just a little wet. Give it a beat, okay? I also got this ice bucket from the Dollar Tree. I put this right inside of my O-Cedar mop, which I'll be sure to link down below. It prevents the dirty water and the clean water from mixing, and it makes such an easy clean. I put just a little splashy dash of this apple-scented Fabuloso right inside of my mop, literally like just a cap full of it, and then I mop up the floor. Here's the before, and oh my goodness, the after. There is no fancy tricks here. Truly, this is just hydrogen peroxide and baking soda, and that is the fastest way possible. I hope you are getting back hours of your time because I have got more tips I want to share with you. In fact, I want you to know that every few days, I spend about 15 minutes reading through all of the new comments that I get. And this is one that I get a lot, dealing with really small spaces. And oh man, not only did a viewer have this question, but another viewer had an answer to this that I had to test out and show you because it worked. This little suction cup hanger that's meant for brushes can be used in small spaces with pedestal sinks. Not only can it hold your makeup and brushes after you clean them, upside down is the best way to let them drip dry. It can hold your lipstick, it can hold toothbrushes, especially in a small space. This is a game changer for $1.25. And maybe this is just my old age, but I wanna get your opinion here. Okay, so the Dollar Tree has a new product. It's this bathroom cleaner that uses 90% less product. It's like some of those more expensive items that come with little refill kits. This one gave me a massive headache. And my goal in this video was that no product I'm sharing with you should give you a headache. I mean, come on now. So here's what I actually do. I get a pitcher from the Dollar Tree. And remember that essentials broom section? We're gonna go back there, and you also need a mop head. Do you know what I use to clean my bathroom most of the time? Soap. Yep, that's right. I take this Brillo spray soap. This is very similar to the Dawn Power Wash, but it's just $1.25. It comes out in that same light, dusty foam. I spray this in the inside of my tub, whether it's my bathtub or my walls, and then I can just scrub with this sponge. This is one of my favorite tricks, and I've had people tag me in videos saying that it was really helpful for them.
This is extremely labor intensive. You literally have to use a lot of elbow grease, but I saw this on Do It on a Dime, and it's way less strain on your body, so I highly recommend you try it.
And that's why I got the pitcher, so it makes it really easy to rinse out the shower or tub super quickly. And bonus, it also serves as a caddy that you can take around your house. And I just want to encourage you that if you have a really small space or something that you don't actually love, it's okay. Soap really does go a long way. And I just want you to know that you can do it. And yes, you are enough. Your space is enough just as it is. And you deserve to have a space that's reflective of a clean home for you. All right, so this scrub-free glass cleaner. I've got some hacks with this, so I don't want you to go anywhere. But yes, this works great right on all of your glass surfaces. And soap, just plain dish soap that you can get at the dollar store, I think works really well on my sink tops. I know a lot of people like to use Ajax or bleach, which I sometimes do use, but also this is just really simple. Another hack that I want to show you guys, it's been a while since I've shared, but man, does it make a difference if you want your faucets to shine like this one. And that is Barbasol. You can get this at the Dollar Tree. I love the smell of this. Why? I don't know. It's just so good. But you put a little bit of this on a microfiber rag and put this on all of your nickel fixtures. I just rub this right in and buff away. You don't have to rinse it at all. And it takes all of those water stains out and gives it such a beautiful shine. Check this out. And the best is yet to come, friends. This video is just getting started. I want you to leave feeling really motivated. All right, glass cleaner. I'm gonna link some down below just in case your Dollar Tree doesn't have it in stock, okay? But we're gonna go unconventional. I want you to go in your bathroom and lift up your drain. This is where a lot of hidden odors hide. Remember, clean smelling spaces, even if your home is older, really helps it feel clean. I spray glass cleaner right down inside of this. You wanna make sure it's the one without ammonia. That's my favorite to use from the Dollar Tree. And yes, that is a toilet bowl cleaner that I use in my bathroom. Of course, I've never put this in my toilet. I have it just for cleaning bathrooms. And giving this a nice scrub makes my shower so fresh. Here is the other hack I want to show you. This glass cleaner goes so far. You want to grab one of those essential floor cleaning mop heads. This is the one that has Velcro on it. You can stick a microfiber rag right on this. And if you have glass or mirrors, windows, whatever it is that's way up high, now you've got it on a stick. This I put together for less than $3. And I use this every single week in my house. It takes up so much grime and I'm able to clean all of my windows and mirrors in half the time. Actually, half the time, y'all. And because the Dollar Tree one is Velcro, you don't have to worry about this hack like it's slipping off of your Swiffer. Like, the Swiffers don't do this. The rags slip off. I know you know what I'm talking about, but it doesn't from the Dollar Tree one, and it lets in all of that beautiful light. And did you know that glass cleaner, yes, glass cleaner, often works in your automobiles and on patio furniture. If you have stains, spray this on. Obviously test in an inconspicuous area first to make sure it's gonna work, but I have done this many times outside and it takes it off. Was it that movie, My Big Fat Greek Wedding, where the Windex did everything? You know what I'm talking about? But this glass cleaner from Dollar Tree is kind of a miraculous product. I also wanna let you know they have Fire Ant Killer there. This is brand new this year. So if you have an outdoor patio or you want some mosquito buggables for your wrist, all of that is available now. These are products that I haven't tried, but they're $5 or $6 at the hardware store, so I thought it best to point them out, especially if you're gonna be spending time outside and you don't want pesky bugs. But if you're like us and you have been traveling, you do wanna know how to clean the inside of your car. I took this same glass cleaner out to my car. I had a couple of stains on the roof. Our van is about 7 years old or so, and I let this sit for just a couple of minutes, and then I buffed it away with a microfiber rag. I was really impressed. This did a great job. Our van is fairly clean, but do you wanna know what was in Charlie's Mazda? It's a 13-year-old car. I would love to get a Jeep, y'all. I really would. Maybe leave a comment for Charlie because he does read them too. Tell him that Kathryn wants a red Jeep. It's really okay though. I am not really a car person. I don't really care about having super fancy stuff. That's not how I roll. So I like to take care of the things that I do have. So I just sprayed on some of this glass cleaner right onto the car mats. And this made it look factory new. And like I said, this is a 13-year-old mat. If we do decide to trade in this vehicle, it's gonna be looking brand new. And speaking of brand new, I've got two more products from the Dollar Tree. This microfiber cloth, and this is the first time I have seen dash and glass at Dollar Tree. This stuff I'd never used, and whoa, was I impressed. This was in the Dollar Tree Plus section, but it is a good deal. It's only $5 and $7 at most other stores. And I just wanna show you how well this works. I think the main reason I liked it is because it's an all-purpose cleaner that works on your dashboard, it works on all of your technology in your vehicle, and it works on the glass, both inside and outside of the car. I am pretty scent picky. I actually really like my scents diluted. I don't like them too pungent, but I did think that this smelled really good. It almost kind of had like a eucalyptus or minty smell, which is the exact type of smell that you want in a dirty car that you're schlepping your kids around in. Also, a brand new product that I found at my Dollar Tree, and I wanna know if it's at yours, Activated Charcoal Odor Eliminator. This is a great natural way to eliminate odors in your car. Just stick it right on the back seat. Let me know if you have tried this one. And they also had a new to me product, Odo Ban. This stuff has really good ratings. I think it's very similar to Pine Sol. You can eliminate strong odors. They also have the bigger jugs for just $5 in the plus section. I put Pine Sol in my washer, and this is another option. You can put it straight in your washing machine. And speaking of sheets, if you want to keep them nice and fresh and bright white, this is my trick. Take a quarter cup of baking soda and sprinkle it into the drum of your washing machine with nothing in it. Then add your sheets on top. Another hack is to go to the Dollar Tree, also Walmart. They have these items really cheaply. You can get hydrogen peroxide. You're just going to put this on any stains. This was a coffee stain. It was a little bit chaotic how that happened. I actually did not do this for camera. Like, it really happened when I was drinking coffee in bed. But anyway, I just put some baking soda on top and then I gave it a scrub and I put this right in my washing machine. This is the before and the after. I've done this for years. It's Miracle White Bright Sheet. If you've got yellowing or you like white bedding, especially white or light pillows, this is the trick you definitely want to remember. And let me know, have you been on a declutter kick? I definitely have, especially those things behind closed doors. If you'd like a declutter with me video and some motivation and encouragement, let me know in the comments down below.
If nobody has told you today, you are enough. I'll catch you soon.
Ah, I actually got it on a thing. Shoot.
Well, it'll clean the lens too.